Subject is English of standard 5 and the name of the lesson is 3 sacks of rice. Yes, dear student, this is the story of brothers. You may have heard many stories about 3 brothers. Usually, 2 of them, the elder ones, are strong, clever, but unkind. They laugh at the youngest one because he is too simple and soft-hearted. Our story also has 3 brothers. And the extra additional parts are their mother and their father's friend. Okay, let us begin our story. Three sacks of rice. There were 3 brothers who lived in a small town, and all 3 were honest, kind, and hardworking. The elder one ran a shop, the middle one was the priest, and the youngest one had just finished his education. Elder brother means the first son. Middle brother means second one. Youngest brother means the smaller one. Okay? The youngest had started taking up odd jobs to earn some money and to learn a trade. All 3 of them were fond of their mother. Okay? She had worked hard to bring up the 3 of them after the sudden death of their father. Means in their house, 3 sons and a mother were there. Okay? One day, their father's friend visited the mother. He said, "Sister, you know that I have a very prosperous business. But now I am getting old and my only daughter is of a marriageable age. I am looking for a son-in-law who would be a good husband to my daughter and who would also handle my business well. I like all your sons. If you permit, I will marry my daughter to one of them, but before that, I have a plan." He discussed the plan with her and she agreed quite readily. The next day, the friend went to each of the 3 brothers one by one. He gave them each a sack of rice and said, "My dear boy, I am going away for a few months for some necessary work. Please look after this sack of rice till I come back," he said, and he went away. Many months passed, but he did not return. It was nearly a year before he came back. He visited the eldest brother first. The eldest brother welcomed him and gave him a small purse full of money. You can see here. And said, "Uncle, you had left a sack of rice with me. But after a few months, I was worried that it may get spoilt. Therefore, I sold the rice to my customers. Here's the money I got. Please accept it." The father's friend said, "Thank you, my boy. You are such an honest person." Then the friend went to see the middle brother, who was a priest. The priest greeted him with joy and affection. He said, "Uncle, remember you had left a sack of rice with me. an year ago. I had kept it for many months, but then I was worried that it may get spoilt. So I distributed the rice among the poor in your name. They all blessed you for satisfying their hunger. However, I did that without your permission, and I am willing to pay you back for the rice. Then the father's friend said, "No, my boy, you acted wisely and kindly. The blessings that I got from the poor people are enough for me. Please don't even think about the money anymore." When the friend went to visit the youngest son, he too welcomed him with love and respect. But he said that he had a confession to make. "The sack of rice was lying with me for a long time, but then I had an idea. I often go to a neighboring village to help with the work of the farm. I borrowed an unused plot of land from the farmer, and I exchanged the sack of rice for paddy and sowed the paddy in the plot. Fortunately, the crop grew well and yielded 25 sacks of rice. I have kept back 5 of the sacks and sold 20 of them. Here is the money. If you allow, I would like to keep a part of it as my share, considering the labor and money I spent to get it all done." A wide smile spread on the friend's face. He had found his future son-in-law. The story is over. Did you understand the story? Nice. Okay, now we will move to the exercise part. Yes, dear students, opposites. You can see here sun and moon, right? Sun comes in the daytime and moon in the night. So opposites. Correct? We will study this in detail. See the picture here, soaked. The opposite is dry. You can see the picture and understand. Start, finish. She started to color the picture and she finished coloring. To borrow, to lend. Active, lazy. See the picture and understand the meaning, okay? Angel, devil. Absent, present. This you know, correct? To come, to go. See the picture. Quiet, loud. Okay? Now we will move to your text. Find the opposites of the following words from the lesson. Yes, so many words are given. We have to find out the opposite words of these words. Begun. The opposite of begun is finished. This is in past tense. Bought. Sold. Reject. I rejected the plan. I accepted the plan. She reject, opposite is accept. Eldest. The opposite of eldest is youngest. Okay. Lent. The opposite of this is borrowed. Earned. Spent. We work to earn the money and we buy things to spend the money. Narrow, broad or wide. Okay. Now, dear students, this is also from your textbook. See language study. Read the highlighted words. All three of them were honest, kind and hardworking. You are such an honest person. Here, the highlighted words are adjectives. Now, find at least 5 other adjectives from the lesson. Okay, this is one question. And second, list as many words as you can that will go with the given adjective. Here, they said at least 3 each. Example, sudden. Here, see, the different words that match with the sudden are sudden change, sudden shower, sudden fall. Like this, we have to make some more words. Okay? First, we will understand the meaning of the adjectives. An adjective describes a noun or a pronoun. Means here, always, the adjectives we use to describe a special character or something more about the noun. See example, happy dog. Dog is the noun and how it is? It is very happy. So it is happy dog. And it shows what kind, which one and how many. Like that, for these questions the adjective gives answer. Second, see that tired boy. The boy is very tired. Now, 7 girls. How many girls are there? 7 girls. You can see here all answers we got for these type of questions. For what, for which, for how many and all that. Okay. An adjective is a word used to describe a noun in various ways. See, Mickey is very happy. It is a tall tree. The book is very thick. See here, speciality or special thing is mentioned about the noun. So we use adjective in our life to describe a thing or a place or a person in a different way. That man is very good. How we say? We describe our feelings about that man. Isn't it? Then we use adjectives. Yeah, adjectives of size and length. See, this store is very big. This animal is very small. Like that, we use adjective to mention the size of the thing or animal or the place. And sometimes we use tall, short, correct? Thick, thin, wide, narrow. This street is very narrow. Like that, we use the words, that is the adjectives to describe the things or the nouns, or sometimes we use adjectives for the pronouns. Words that go with adjective sudden are sudden, sudden change, sudden shower. This we have taken from the textbook. Sudden fall, sudden death. Correct? Like this, we have to make the list of the adjectives that go with the given word from the textbook, okay? one more is simple. Here also, words that go with the adjective simple are simple reason. Sometimes we say, na, this is very simple reason. Simple job. Simple meal. If only rice, dal, roti and vegetable is there, then we say that this is a very simple meal. Correct? Simple person. If a person is very simple, means he wears the proper simple clothes and all that, then we say this man is very simple. Correct? Odd. The words that go with the adjective odd are odd behavior, odd look, odd feeling, odd number. Okay? Only. Words that go with adjective only are only student, means here we say numbers. Only child, means only one child. Only mother. Only answer. Words that go with adjective honest are honest broker, honest person, honest businessman, honest servant, honest policeman. Okay, like this we can list many more for these words. Words that go with adjective long are long coat. Here length or size is mentioned. Long shower. Long stick. Long time. Okay? Find out how rice is cultivated. Describe the process with the help of pictures or diagrams. Dear students, you know that the cultivation, means the agriculture, is the main occupation of our country. More than 70% are employed in agriculture. Correct? Now, there are different processes or steps are there in the agriculture and in the rice cultivation. See there, step 1, field preparation. Step 2, flooding and seeding. Step 3, maturation of rice. Step 4, harvest. Step 5, milling and storage. We will go through these all steps from the pictures. See dear students, here we can see field is preparing. See this farmer, he is busy in preparing the field for the cultivation of rice. The cultivation of rice begins by planting water-soaked seeds in a properly prepared bed. You can see here, oftentimes the seedlings are transplanted to the paddy when they reach a certain size. When the grains begin to ripen, the water is drained from the fields. Here you can see they are matured, and here we can see the grains of rice. Harvesting begins when the grain yellow and the plants start to droop. In the last picture, we can see the harvesting. Harvesting means cutting. Okay? Yeah, we can see a girl is cutting the crop, means she is harvesting. The crop is ripened, so she is cutting that. After cutting, they make the bundles and they carry that crops to the clean and safe place to make it dry. They make the bundles of that and they keep under the sun to dry. Okay. After that, they do threshing. See, they thresh the crop so that to separate the grains from the straw to which they are attached. After that, the process of winnowing is carried out. Here, winnowing means blowing a current of air through the grains in order to remove the chaff. Here, the grains are separated from the chaff. And after that, the grains are stored in the sacks and they are transported. Okay, this is the process of rice cultivation. Got this, students? See, this is advanced farming technology. Here we use some of the advanced machines which help in farming so that we get improved quality of the product. Okay?